In this video, we will be discussing how and when to use the T-interval tool within Google Sheets. So let's begin. So it can be a common confusion of when to use the T-interval or the Z-interval. As you can see in the bottom of the tab, we have the T and Z-interval. Right now we're on T-interval. And let's switch back and forth between these two tabs. And you'll notice that there's a difference in this area right here, that we have sample standard deviation and population standard deviation. With sample standard deviation, it's for T-interval, and population standard deviation for Z-interval. So if you are given the sample standard deviation in a problem, and you do not have population standard deviation, then use T-interval. But if you have the population standard deviation given to you in the problem, use Z-interval. Now let's look in this problem and see. We have the effectiveness of blood pressure drug is being investigated. An experimenter finds that on average, the reduction of systolic blood pressure is 76.3 for a sample of size 617 and standard deviation 15.4. So as you can see here, we are not given the population standard deviation, because we'll see that the standard deviation and the mean and the sample size, all of that is given from a sample. So we can establish that in this problem, we are not given population standard deviation. And you can just tell by the wording typically. And in this case, we are not given population standard deviation. So we are not using Z-interval. We are using T-interval. So T-interval is when population standard deviation is unknown. And so the next best thing we have is sample standard deviation. But if we have a sample standard deviation and not population standard deviation, we have a T-distribution. So we're dealing with T-confidence interval. So we'll be using this tool for this problem. And we have four unknowns that we had to fill in, the orange cells. So we change the orange cells. We do not change these cells down here. Do not change. These will automatically be calculated for you. So we need four different values. And as you can see, there's four numbers here in this case. And the we have 76.3 is the on average. It's the mean. The sample mean. So we have the sample mean. And then we have a sample size, sample of size 617. And we have a sample standard deviation of 15.4. And again, it doesn't say sample standard deviation, but it mentions that from the sample of size 617, we have a standard deviation of 15.4. So you can typically tell from the wording. And it'll typically say from previous knowledge, or we can assume the population standard deviation is something. So you can tell by the wording if it is population standard deviation, if it actually mentions it. As you can see from here, the standard deviation is based off of a sample. So we know it's a sample standard deviation. Lastly, we need confidence level. The confidence level is determined based on right here using a 98% confidence level. So in this case, we would want to put it in decimal form. So that would be 0.98, converting 98% to decimal form. And after you have those four inputs, after you click out of that last cell, we will have all of our calculations we need. Now, it mentions here, enter your answer as a trilinear inequality, accurate to one decimal place. So you should know how to round here, but we want to use the lower bound and upper bound for this. And so this is just one way to express a confidence interval when in a trilinear inequality. And it's saying that the population mean, mu, the symbol right here, we're estimating is in between the lower bound and the upper bound. So with 98% confidence. And just an interpretation, this represents 98% of all confidence intervals, if we were to construct, would contain the true population mean. We don't actually know what the true population mean is, but we'd expect to capture that 98% of the time. And this is just one confidence interval. If we were to do this repeatedly with a whole different sample and gather a new sample, we would expect to capture the true population mean, whatever that happens to be, 98% of the time. Okay, that's just a quick interpretation. But so this is the solution, the lower and upper bound. Okay, here we go.